Hey everyone, and happy Tuesday! It's going up on a Tuesday with your girl hashtag JLone in the building. Of course, coming at you with new information, new education, and just a great smile to make your day, okay? So today's day, before we get into what our mortgage tip is today is National Brothers and Sisters Day. I was blessed beyond belief with an amazing, amazing sister in my life. And I love her to death. Our bond is amazing. And then through marriage, I was also given some fantastic sisters. And I just wanted to tell them today that I love them. And I didn't have any brothers or anyone else. And so thank you so much for being a vital part of my life. But today, if you have brothers and you have sisters, give them a shout out. Life is short. Even if you're mad at them, just send them a message and say, hey, I'm thinking about you. And I just want you to know that I love you. And I hope you have a fantastic day. Okay? So today I want to talk about seller concessions. And what are seller concessions and what can you do with them? How can they help you when you're trying to buy a loan? I'm sorry, buy a home. Use JLone. And so I wanted to talk to you a little bit about this because we're at a time in a market now where, you know, sellers are a little looser and they are providing seller concessions. And so I want to talk about that real quick, okay? So the number one question is, well, what are seller concessions, right? So seller concessions is, to sum it up, is the amount of money that a seller is willing to contribute to your closing cost. So when you close the loan, they will give you a certain dollar amount that will help you come out of pocket. I think it's very important for me to stop for a second and explain that a lot of the times, you will see these 100% down programs and a borrower will call and believe that because it's 100% that they do not have to come to closing with any money. And it's very important to know again that buying a home, there's two sides of that. There's your down payment and then there's your closing costs. And so that could range, your closing costs could range, I mean, from 2 to 5% depending on how much the property is. And so it's important for you to actually have to account for that that savings that you have, because even if you get 100% financing through VA or USDA, you still have to have that back end cost. And this is where seller concessions can come in and it can help you, okay? So number two, what can they be used for? Super important. Well, what can this be used for? So of course your closing costs, because it's gonna contribute to your closing costs. But it's not limited to these things, but your appraisal cost, your attorney fees, the biggest one that I love to see, if you have the savings and you can pay for your closing costs, have the seller pay for your interest rate buy down, especially in this market today where interest rates are higher than we're comfortable with, right? Or what we're used to, should I say. This is a great option to use that money and buy down your interest rate. Origination fees. So every lender has some sort of origination fee and they can pay for that. Your title insurance fee. Your seller, if they're not paying for this, depending on the price of the property, that's thousands of dollars that will save you money out of pocket. Then you have your real estate taxes. And then one that people don't use often is it can pay for your single or your split premium mortgage insurance premiums on your loan that will help you buy out not having that mortgage insurance. So that is an option as well, okay? Now, what can seller concessions not be used for? Super, super important to know that a seller cannot pay for your down payment. That must come from you, a gift, your 401k, down payment assistance, but they cannot contribute to your down payment. You must have that coming from somewhere, okay? So it's super important to know that. Also know that, you know, they can't give you cash back at closing, okay? They can't just give you $5,000. It's not allowed. They cannot buy your new refrigerator or your appliances. There's things that they're just not allowed to do. Now, if they buy them and they put them in the house already, that's between y'all, but it cannot be a part of the transaction, okay? Now, what is the max contributions allowed? Because the seller just can't give you whatever they want. It's just not allowed in the guidelines. And we all know there's always guidelines that we have to follow. And we may not agree with them, but they're always there, okay? So the number one thing is on FHA and USDA, the max contributions is 6%. So 6% of your loan amount, they cannot contribute more than that towards your closing costs. And then your VA is 4%. And then your conventional, if you're less than 10% down, that's 3% is their max. It's super important to know that if you're working with a great loan officer like myself, and they are contributing more than you actually have the cost for, we will look into not only paying your closing costs, but also buying down your interest rate as well. So there's ways that we can get creative to really benefit and help you, not only your out-of-pocket, but helping you with your monthly payment, which is super, super important, because I know affordability is a big topic today, and everybody wants to live in a home and feel comfortable and not be house poor. And one thing that is known in housing industry, taxes and insurances will always increase. It's never, very rare that they ever decrease. And so if we're able to get you a lower principal and interest, the one thing that will stay the same throughout the life of the loan, then as your mortgage payment fluctuates for taxes and homeowners insurance, it won't be that much of a big effect on you. So I hope that this information was super helpful. Again, this is about seller concessions. If you have any questions or want to run any scenarios by me, if you're looking for a home loan and I just feel so warm and fuzzy and I'm the one that you want to talk to, please reach out to me at 817-601-5456. As always, it's your girl, J-Loan, and I'm hoping that you have a fantastic rest of your week. I want you to stay safe, be blessed. Until next Tuesday, I'll talk to you then. Bye-bye.